प्रोग्रेसिव मैगजीन जनवरी 2020 ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 3 और 4 स्टार्ट। ओवर द पास्ट मंथ 20 मिलियंस रेसिडेंट ऑफ द नेशनल कैपिटल रीजन हैव सेव्ड ऑफ एट लीस्ट सम पार्ट ऑफ देयर लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसीज बाय ब्रीथिंग इन दिस रीजन्स पॉइजनस एयर। Not only is this one of the most pressing public health disasters of our time, it can also chokehold major initiatives of this government, such as the Make in India campaign and the ease of doing business rankings being promoted internationally, which rational international player would want to put his or her health in risk to come to the most polluted place on earth to do business. Air quality index measures the concentration of fine particulate matter in the air. As a benchmark, the US Environmental Protection Agency considers any value between 0 and 50 to represent good air quality. But this season, areas in the NCR have seen record-breaking values of as high as 1000 on the index, 20 times the prescribed limit for dignified human existence. What makes PM2.5 particles extremely dangerous in their cancerous ability to penetrate the human body and stick onto bench liabilities in our own experience, 1 in 5 people at my company in Gurgaon have reported sick within a week alone. My child's school had to be closed as a precaution. When it did not reopen, the setting of mask-clad children in smoke made the school seem less likely a place of study. As a parent, I feel awful that my child has to breathe this air because I made Delhi my home. As much as 100 immediate deaths would rightfully demanded national attention as a disaster, millions of slow deaths from an even more urgent disaster. What is making this problem invisible? A large part of the answer ties into Delhi's geography. The cold fronts that originate from the north of city look in pollutants close to the ground and within the region. Lack of wind speed and low temperatures stagnate and solidify the pollutants that intensifies their effect. It is as if you kept realizing pollutants inside a house with very poor ventilation. According to a recent study carried out by IIT Kanpur, the mix of sources responsible for PM2.5 changes seasonally in the region. In winters, vehicular emissions account for 25% of PM2.5, 30% is accounted for by others. Transcription number 4, start. Long-term strategies need to be implemented to prevent these from becoming a matter of annual recurrence. Here is how that can be done. First, by the creation and institutionalization of independent task force not directly answerable to either Delhi or central governments. Such a task force should be singularly responsible for and have the authority to enforce measures to manage air pollution in the region. Policy makers often tend to pass the buck onto each other when they are not directly responsible for a project or have interlayered responsibilities. Assigning a single manager responsible for a clear action item drastically improves execution. Second, we need to fundamentally prioritize clean air as a basic human right. To do this, the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan should incorporate clean air as one of its core tenets. A budget for clean air programs should be allocated from the receipts collected from the Swachh Bharat tax. That money should be used to improve vehicle emission standards, subsidize alternatives to fuel wood, and subsidize effective crop burning techniques in North Indian states. Third, increase the renewable purchase obligations of power as well as of state-run distribution companies in and around Delhi and Haryana. Such increases in obligations combined with the growth of renewable energy sources will phase out dependence on coal in the region. Fourth, smarter management of cold fronts. While we cannot control cold fronts per se, we can control the activities that reduce the intensity of pollution during these periods. Reduction in construction activity, odd even, for example, during the winters, can reduce the concentration on PM2.5. Newspapers around the world, from Washington Post, Wall Street Journal, and the New York Times to the Korean Herald and the Daily Mail, have taken notice and highlighted the severity of the problem here in India. Thousands of citizens on Twitter have shared as many dreadful visuals of the reality of the pollution and trended Delhi smog on the social media website for days. The negative publicity has certainly dulled our ability to attract foreign investment, foreigners, non-resident Indians, and out-of-state Indian talent to the region. This crisis imposes costs on society as a whole, as well on the progressive policies that we hope will deliver to us a better economic future. At the base level, the state needs to provide the most basic of human rights, clean air to breathe. Without this, the economic development vision will not have much meaning to the people of the country. The state should make clear policy in this regard to safeguard the health of the people at the earliest possible time. Stop.